I'm Susan Allen Mann. I'd like to share my thoughts on conflict resolution. I hope these will help you think about conflicts you engage in, and that you will also share your approaches to conflict too. With the goal of catalyzing mutual learning, this section of the Global Challenges course on conflict resolution will consider: first, an explanation of what I mean by the term conflict and the term conflict resolution. Second, we'll look at conflict analysis. Conflict analysis offers an invitation to notice conflict dynamics and some tools for analyzing conflicts and their dynamics. And third, we'll look at conflict resolution practice. That section will offer an invitation to notice the processes by which we resolve conflict. There are many frameworks and questions that help us notice our conflict processes. When we are aware of more options for conflict resolution processes, we are better able to choose the options that best match a particular situation. I'll now focus on the first of these. What is conflict and what is conflict resolution? I call something a conflict when some of the people involved feel they have to struggle against others to meet their needs. The idea of need is culturally determined, so each person can clarify for themselves, in their own context, what they really need. Needs may be honoring their identity, physical survival of their body, people, way of life, religion, or sense of justice, and so on. Even a misunderstanding could become a conflict if one person perceives they have to struggle against others to meet their needs. It could be there is a way to meet their needs as a parent to others, but whenever someone sees the only way as struggle against other people, then there is a conflict. So there can be conflicts that are not recognized by many people. One person or group sees a situation as a conflict and others do not. Thus, naming something as a conflict can be part of the way to conflict resolution. This brings me to explaining what I mean by conflict resolution. Conflict resolution is the process of people trying to find ways that everyone's needs can be met. In other words, we shift from struggling against another person or group to struggling together to find a way everyone can be satisfied. Sometimes we shift from dividing a pie to expanding the pie. Sometimes we shift from working within one box of issues in a conflict to thinking outside the box to find ways to address everyone's needs. Sometimes we agree to struggle over parts of an agreement, not necessarily getting what outcome everyone wants on a particular issue, but overall we are aiming to create a situation that everyone is satisfied with. For example, my boys might be satisfied by rolling a dice and seeing who rolls a higher number. And then they agree to a solution based on one boy winning and the other losing. And this is satisfying for them because they are protecting their identities as fair brothers who do not take advantage of each other and are not taken advantage of, at least not often. Sometimes the process is as simple as rolling a die, drinking some tea together, or maybe it is more formal, such as talking with a mediator, or even more formal as in the court system or international negotiations, leading to legal treaties between states. You probably noticed already that I am not offering a recipe that fits for all situations. Conflict resolution is not about following particular models over and over again, no matter what the situation or no matter what feelings are involved. Instead, conflict resolution is about knowing a variety of approaches that can help in a variety of contexts and learning how to match approaches to contexts and then to adapt as conflicts change. Conflicts do change over time, and the approach that works one month may not be appropriate later. We need to adapt. And by raising our awareness of conflict dynamics and conflict resolution processes, we have more vocabulary with which to craft our adaptive stories. This video allows only a brief introduction to parts of the conflict resolution field. It is an introduction and only to part of the field. As you view this introduction in the subsequent videos, I invite you to focus on your own experience with conflicts. We all learn from our experience. Share your insights. Look at some of the resources posted here to find ways of making sense of the conflicts you face. Engage in the discussion section of this course. We can learn together. None of us has to figure it out all on our own. Conflict analysis and conflict resolution practice raise big questions. Who labels the situation as a conflict? Who labels a process a conflict resolution process? Who has the power to name these things and shape these situations and processes? Can every conflict be truly resolved? What conflict resolution processes that are successful in one context can help in another context? We'll explore these in the next segments. These questions are worth exploring together. As with other global challenges, conflict resolution approaches will not develop to be constructive globally, unless we have strong involvement from the many approaches to conflict resolution. This course segment can be complemented by perspectives from other cultures and approaches. So please, engage in the discussions here and continue to the segments when I speak about conflict analysis and then about conflict resolution practice. Thank you.